Kitabu cha Ezekieli 16 aya ya 6 ambapo tunataka tuzungumzie zaidi ndio elewe kwamba baadhi ya mambo ambayo tunakwenda na tunayapitia, baadhi ya mambo hayo huwa yanakuwa sehemu moja ya vita vya mtu katika maisha yake. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hakuna kitu kibaya ambapo kinaitwa vita kama vita vya ndani kwa ndani. Bwana asifiwe sana. You know, some vita zingine ukipigwa ni mzuri sana kwa sababu umepigwa nje unajiandaa. Lakini vita vyako vya ndani huwa vinakuwa vizito sana. Hebu nisomee kitabu hicho cha Ezekiel 16 verse number 6. Hebu soma translation yako. Ezekiel 16 verse number 6. Alafu ndio turudi tusome Deuteronomy chapter number 7 tusome baadaye. Soma Cleophas.
Nami nilipopitia karibu nawe nikakuona ukikakaa katika damu yako.
Ukigaga, hiyo ni Kiswahili, kizungu inasemaje? Yako wewe kizungu inasemaje? Edu yako una New King James Version? New King James Version. Please read that one. Read it. Read it. It's very powerful. That one, the new. Yeah. New King James Version. The New King. Soma yo Cleophas, the New King James Version. Ezekiel 16, verse number 6.
And when I passed by you, I saw you struggling in your own blood.
That's the word I was looking for. I saw you doing what?
Struggling in your own blood.
Not in any other blood. So I said yesterday, there are generational battles that people are fighting. Which are these battles? They are in many versions. They are character battles. There are some characters you are fighting to come out of it. Kuna tabia, sindi onyosho. There are some characters you are fighting to come out of. You love God. You love God the end. You love, there are people who love God. Kuna watu wanapenda Mungu kabisa. If they are sisters, if they are men, they love God to the end. They praise, they can sing, they can dance, they can do virtually everything in the name of loving God. But there are things that are not available. They are not coming out of their life. There are people who have attended their spirit of lies. They love God. If you see them singing and dancing, giving offerings, they love God. They are happy that God loves them. What does your son? But there are battles within them. Even when they don't want to lie, they find themselves lying. Praise the Lord. These are battles of families. These are battles of generation. These are battles that you must identify. The Bible says, and I saw you struggling in your own. So there are things that are in the blood. They are not in the head. They are what? There are some things, satanic spirits of tribalism. They are not in the head. Even the educated. Even the most religious, the most born again, when it comes to a tribe, their blood starts oozing. This is even new. To marry a woman in the church, you want to marry, you are excited, this is a great woman. But the moment you ask from which tribe, then your countenance changes. You are battling between choosing God and the destiny. And you discover also truth. You are struggling in your own blood. Your own what? I say your own what? So sometimes you go in a place where some unacceptable behaviors. Yani there are things you are struggling. Kuna mambo nangangana ndani yako. Yani you are not telling anybody. Nobody is aware about it. Nobody is going to. And you cannot even publicly speak about it. When I say that. They are sisters, they are men and women. People, even sometimes, when people are engaging and talking out there, they want to marry. Some characters, somebody may not say it openly. Sini kweli jerimu. Unaweza mwambia mwanamke mimi na nangorodanga usiku ama nakulaga ulimi usiku. Can you say about this? A sister, there's a sister. I remember very well the year 2003, even though 2004. this sister, she was successfully, extremely powerful lady, loves God, do everything in church. She was a very beautiful lady, good figure. Everything you look at her character, she's very powerful. But this sister, she was a bedwetting. Even the day, the one day she had to confront the demon by speaking. She had gone to Makini. She had gone to this thing. How do you call this? Imadawa madawa ya vienyeji hapa town. Inajua Makini, Abo, these Abos, Murugu, all those madawa. Yeah, kweli kabisa. And this sister, she was named after her own auntie, who was the same name. Named after her. The auntie was never married because she was very dirty. And this kid, and in health, she was a grown up. She was the same age actually, that time. We were in the same church, same everywhere. She was from the same family. One day, even when we were with another pastor, you remember the pastor George who died? When we were together, one day she called us and she bought us lunch right there, cooking. And now she started to confine the same thing and say, Pastor, look at me. I want to get married. I want to be somebody's wife. But my greatest fear, it is that I bed what? And sometimes, na unajua ukiwa mtu mzima, ukojoe kwa kitanda na unaga watoto kwa nyumba. It is very shameful to go uanike mattress nje. Si ni kweli? Utaenda kuanika mattress nje na unaishi peke yako na watu wanajua Jerima hakuna watoto wamekutembelea. Na mattress upaya makojoo huwa inajichora. Watu wanajua hii si maji, hii ni makojoo na inajichora. Who was there? And you know you have no. So she's struggling. She do what? This is a that are within. How can you overcome it? Number one, you may not openly say about it. I remember that time. That's the first time I told her you will never. We confronted and started naming her until we gave her even a name. We never even gave her the name Esther. We say you are a dancer, a queen, a shining star. That God, I'm happy that today, one day I stumbled on her on a Facebook. Two married, and she was married by the pastor. Two children, beautiful kids. I was the most happy man. Why? Because that time she decided to say, this battle, I must take it to another level. And I pray that every battle in your life, God will give you grace and confidence to take it to another level. I say you take it to another level. There are battles that some of them are genetic. They are generational. You are fighting what your mother fought. And where she stopped, you have started it again. Amen? There are battles that you are not even aware of it. You don't know the kind of weapon were used at that time. You don't know what they were doing. You cannot even tell the genesis of the battles. How many here today, as I'm talking, you have inherited your father's boundaries? My brother fought. I remember, I can never forget, I was a young kid like this. Before my father died, there was the Catholic Church in from our village. I can't tell how many acres of land, but they took it. We had issues. I was told my brothers came, they fought, they died. My mother died. I came when I was young. I was told some things I could not trust. I inherited some battles from my brothers until one day I made the decision and said, God, give me grace, I may disappear, lest I die as they die. So that's why I'm praying that every battle that your family and your relatives fought, God shall give you the grace. You shall not die, but you shall overcome it, and God give you grace to overcome it. I said, God shall give you grace to overcome it. There are battles you are fighting. You are fighting divorce from your family. Your mother was divorced. Your mother was harassed. Your mother was. There are things that happened in your family you cannot even explain. You got a very nice guy. By the time you get married, you are happy. Happy. You could tell everybody about your husband. All of a sudden, the man has changed. Is there not the same man with the same tone? Is there not the same guy who can talk the way he was talking before? The man has changed completely. Why? Because this guy has taken, because there's a certain pattern of life, at a certain period, after two children, after three children, after four children, after the fat part of a kid, there's a lady who was here. She's a member in this church. She told us that one of the testimonies, very strong. She said, anytime she's expectant, before she delivers a child, because she was giving us a chronology of her, she has three children. At every time anapata mimba, akienda kukaribia kuzaa, anavutwa kazi, na anateseka. Who can remember how many? I've seen Anatoseka for how long? Anatoseka more than, not more than 2 or 3 years. Mtoto akiza. Anytime wanaza, anytime anasoma, she's skillful, akona kila kitu. Lakini the moment anaza, baada ya kuza, ama baada kupokea mimba, then the problem begins. Si ati kumwa, si kuza, si kupasuliwa, lakini na preso wana, si ati anashindwa kufanya kazi. The moment kabla hajafanya, at contrary, when the pregnancy is at the prime stage, 1 month or 2 months, anatafutiwa kisirani, anavutwa kazi. Akatuambia kwanza mtoto wake, Nairobi walikuwa anakula sijui nini. Yani the firstborn. She's a very beautiful girl. The firstborn. Sasa, every time anajua, the moment, so, maybe akiata kuzaa, then ana problem. Anaweza endelea na kazi, anaweza endelea kufanya kazi. So, there are some battles you inherit. There are some battles that you begin yourself. There are battles that are caused by your friends. You are suffering because of your friends. Have you ever been in that battles? Maikuwa kwa vida ya marafiki, bwana siwe sana. Unatembea na dada ambaye aliachwa na mume, na huyo mume ama alichoma mwanamume, na unajua you cannot be able to come out of that sister's, ni rafiki. Na ujui saka mzatazi ya kuchoma mume wake ama kumugonga ama whichever happen. Unanielewa? There are pastors I work with them. Sometimes, alafu mtu anakuambia, wewe unatembea na mtu alitupa bibi. You know, sasa unaongea. I was in Kisumu. And somebody was talking like a nurse and nurses. I told him, thank God you are with your wife. But you don't know the demon that I was fighting him. You can suspend them and transfer to your house. You can know whether you will stand it. Kuna shida mtu anapitia Jerimo, nikikuomba 100 unaweza 100 tu ndio unaombaga. Maiona rich, somebody gave me this thing and I was very happy about it. I was telling pastor about it. Poor people talks, they keep on pursuing money so that they can become famous, wasumbue watu, wakanyage watu. Sio kweli? Rich people wanaanza kuongea chini ya vitu. Najua siku hizi nimebadilisha gari, najua sasa niko siku hizi niko hapa. Those are the rich people who are nothing. Rich people cannot reach anything. But what are born, they are wealthy. There is a difference between rich and wealthy. Nanielewa? People die at wealthy, at riches. They never go even beyond wealth. People are wealthy, they don't even talk about properties. Nanielewa? We were with another man in Nairobi. I, Bishop Mark, Masinde JB, Apostle Boseli, and your friend Nganga, and some of those guys, while we were in the same forum. So, and the process, you know, the poor guys who are there. Bishop Mark was not talking. These characters who are poor came, who got money the other day, they can talk. Unajua niko na nyumba Karen. Unajua niko na zui nini. Unajua gari yangu hata haisavisi wagi hapa. Poor people talk about their cars, and you think they are rich. Unanyara waki? But serious guys don't talk about cars. Unatoka, ametoka hapo inje, ameingia kwa gari. Even precious. That's what is making people come. You compete. Wamama ole matajiri. Mami tulienda na wewe kwa office of the president. This lady was a senior civil servant, the greatest woman in this country. Amechukua tu matuta, amefunga nywele upande hii, na anaendelea na ako hapa hivi, na anaendelea kawaida. Maskini, anajisumbua, anajipoto, anatesa watu. But you ask God, if she comes even a quarter of what is happening, ni nini itafanyika? Si kila mtu atakufa hii dunia. Have you seen poor? Mtu ameolewa kutoka Kaptembo hapa, apelekwa hapa milimani kidogo, apata wasichana wanapanguza kwa nyumba hapa. Anachukua time hata kama Jezebel. Anakaa kwa kio kama tu. Kuja, there's another lady we went in the house. Wasichana, ameambula wasichana, ameweka maji kwa mikono, kwa miguu. Hebu nisugue hapa vizuri, nisugue. Nikajua maskini wako na tabia za kutosha. Wanaishi wasiwe sana. Wako na vita vya kumaliza vya umaskini. So the devil is taking them to another level where they fit. So they are what you call inherited battles. Inherited what? Inherited what? When we were coming in this house, this hall, we found there was a debt was here. Na tuliambiwa kwamba before you negotiate anything, you must make sure you settle. It was an accumulated debt. But then it was over 30,000. We were told you must first of before we talk, before we think, before we imagine, make sure. And then we came again, we found another debt, Yamaj. And we were told they said debt, Yamaj, Ikoapa. And again, 6,800, you must clear this one, you must clear railway this one, you must clear. And because you are desperate, you must do what? I said you must what? You must fight to clear. So what is delaying your blessing? Not that because God doesn't want it to be your destiny, but you are being delayed because there are some inherited battles. But I pray that Jehovah who lives in heaven and who shall give us the grace for 2017, he shall give you the courage that the inherited battles, you shall overcome them. I say you shall overcome them in the name of Jesus Christ. There are some inherited battles. Battles. That's why I even encourage gay women who want to get married to a man who is divorced. Number one, sit down and ask yourself 101 questions. Are you ready to continue with the same character? Because the man may look very powerful, very nice, but you don't know what is it. What? Are you? Do you have a grace? Do you have a grace? Do you have a grace? Do you have a grace of continuing? Because this is an inherited pattern. A man who has stayed with a woman for 10 years, a woman who has stayed in some place for 5 years, she has given birth to children, and she wants to migrate. She's moving to another level. Are you ready for the same? Because it is not about how you can say, one has fewer. Have you seen people in the church who are struggling with the same things? Bwana asifiwe sana. Kusengenya watu. Mtu anakuwa kanisani. Na apendi. Anainua. Ukimwona ameinua mikono. Anaomba mpaka analia. Anakaja chavu. Dakika tano haijaisha anavuta mtu kwa kona. Hapa kwa church. Hata si nje ya kanisa. Hapa kwa kona. Tunasamana. Maneno mengine naona. And the way she was so spiritual, you think she has already overcome. She's struggling in her own. I said, blah. Yani kusengenya hiko kwa damu, haiko kwa kirio kwa nini? I say, hiko kwa nini? Sini kweli edu? Sini kweli? Kwa mfano kama Kenya, for example, we put Kenya, for example. Let's just make Kenya, for example, an example. This country. Tribalism in Kenya is not in the head. It is where? Look up. We are coming to election this year by August. Every preacher who come from Western or wherever, Ruland, and then those one who come from Central, even on these other small tribes who look like Omena, they are going to add on. They said that everybody, every preacher from his region, this time round, they are not spiritual. They are not what? They are not going to be spiritual. They will resurrect after September, October is when they are now going to regain back the other new blood. That time when we will minister Holy Communion like fire, so that at least we may. Because that time, I'm telling the truth. I have a pastor friend, every time he calls me, and I'm picking him, my wife and I joke even. And I told him, Pastor, I don't vote. And I'm picking him, hey, hello, Askof, mutu wa Jubilee. Namambia, you are a fool. And this guy, and he's my senior. Hey, mtu wa Jubilee, sasa umekula vitu za Jubilee. And he, hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Namambia, na nikimupigia, namuuliza, tulienda na bibi yangu kwa ofisi yake, ni pastor mkubwa. Ameweka picha ya baba kwa pastor. That's why I have no photo for Odinga or for Uhuru in my office. I'm not a businessman. I recognize him as the president of the Republic of Kenya.